After he had been flogged and his back had been ripped to shreds, gladly took that crossbeam, but he couldn't make it down that Via Dolorosa. He had to have help by a man from North Africa named Cyrene. But our Lord submitted himself to that because he loves us. Amen?
Amen.
This next song is called Via Dolorosa.
To Calvary.
Man of sorrows, what a name for the Son of God who came, ruined the sinners to reclaim. It is finished, was his cry. Now in heaven, exalted high, alleluia, what a Savior. When he
to see the dawn of the darkest day, Christ on the road to Calvary, tried by sinful men, torn and beaten, then nailed to a cross of wood. This the power
Shouldn't have been. It was in prophecy, but everyone was surprised. They were surprised that Christ had died. They didn't expect that. They expected him to come in and destroy Rome. But he did die. And it says in Matthew 28 that on the first day of the week, around dawn, Mary Magdalene, the one that had been possessed of seven demons, she went to the tomb. Mary Magdalene was the last at the cross, and she was first at the tomb to see the risen Christ. And it says that, behold, there was an earthquake, and an angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing white as snow. And for fear of him, the guards trembled and became like dead men. The angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid, for I know that you seek Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has risen, as he said. Come see the place where the Lord, where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples that he has risen from the dead, and behold, he is going before you in Galilee, and there you will see him." And you remember that Mary was there tarrying at the tomb, and she saw someone and thought it was the gardener. And she said, "Please, sir, tell me, where have you laid my Lord? Where did you put his body?" And she saw him, and he looked at her and simply said her name, Mary. And she responds, "Rabboni, teacher, master, Lord, it's you. You're risen from the dead." He's risen from the dead. Tell it everywhere.
Amen.
Hear the bells ringing, they're singing that you can be born again. Bells ringing, they're singing, Christ is risen from the dead. The angel up on the tombstone said, "He has risen just as he said. Quickly now, go tell his disciples that Jesus Christ is no longer dead. Joy to those has risen. Hallelujah, he has risen. Hallelujah, he has risen. Hallelujah. Singing that you can be healed right now. Hear the bells ringing, they're singing, Christ, he will reveal it now. The angels, they all surround us and they are ministering Jesus's power. Quickly now, reach out and receive it, for this could be your glorious hour. Joy to the world, he has risen. Hallelujah, he has risen. Hallelujah, he has risen. Hallelujah, hallelujah. The angel upon the tombstone said, he has risen just as he said. Quickly now, go tell his disciples that Jesus Christ is no longer dead. Joy to the world, he has risen. Hallelujah, he has risen. Hallelujah, he has risen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Amen.
We read in Romans 6 that we were united with Christ in his death, in order that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might walk in newness of life. The Bible says in Romans 8:11, the same Spirit who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you in his resurrection power. And Paul says that I may know him and the power of his resurrection. Because Jesus lives, I can face tomorrow, all because he lives. Amen?
Amen.
I believe in the Son. I believe in the risen one. I believe I overcome by the power of his blood. Amen. Amen. I'm alive. I'm alive because he tomorrow. because he lives, every fear is gone. I know he holds my life, my future in his hands. Amen. Amen. I'm alive because he lives. Amen. Amen. Let my song join the one that never ends. Because